As soon as the House of Representatives' proposed tax reform bill had hit the news, divorce lawyer Malcolm Taub's phone started to buzz. The tax deduction for alimony was on the chopping block, eliminating the break for the spouse who pays alimony and the tax hit for the one who receives it. Americans are more likely to believe the wealthy will benefit most from the tax reform currently being pushed by Republicans who insist their goal is to help the middle class, according to a Reuters Ipsos opinion poll. World. U.S. President Donald Trump sent out a strong message on trade at a meeting of Asia-Pacific countries in Vietnam, saying the United States could no longer tolerate chronic trade abuses and would insist on fair and equal policies. France's foreign minister said he believed that former Lebanese Prime Minister Saad al-Hariri was not under house arrest in Saudi Arabia and did not have any particular constraints on his movements. A Hezbollah-run media unit said Islamic State leader Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi was reported to have been in the Syrian town of al-Bukamal during the Syrian army and its allies' operation to clear it. Britain's Prime Minister Theresa May should stop misleading voters and admit that Brexit can be avoided if Britain decides to unilaterally scrap divorce talks, the man who drafted Article 50 of the Lisbon Treaty said. Along a stretch of highway in suburban Bayamon, Puerto Rico, construction workers tried desperately to make progress repairing a 100-foot-long sinkhole before the clouds rolled in. The crater was among thousands of sites damaged by a storm that exposed an already fragile infrastructure in Puerto Rico, decimating water, power and roadways all at once. China. Reuters TV, surveillance and silence in China's democracy village. Chinese venture capital and private equity funds are pouring hundreds of millions of dollars into local startups serving up snack food products of the healthier kind and threatening the market share of larger Chinese and global food companies. China will raise foreign ownership limits in financial firms in a step granting access to a tantalizing multi-trillion dollar financial services market, as the world's second biggest economy seeks to position itself as a major global finance hub. Breaking views: China's Singles Day kicks off nearly a month of discounts and promotions. The extravaganza means lots of free PR and huge transaction volumes for $480 billion behemoth Alibaba. An Australian green tree frog named Godzilla sits during the launch of the Australian Museum's National Frog Count phone app called Frogit in Sydney, Australia, November 10, 2017. Reuters David Gray.